Our paper has just recently been published in Nature. Of course, we are very proud, very happy about it. Beyond that, I truly believe that this is an important discovery with far-reaching potential consequences.
Our upcoming paper, it's about branch flow of light. This is a very interesting phenomenon which really opens up a new direction in optics. We discovered that in a soap bubble. My student Tolik, Patsyk found a way how to freeze the soap because otherwise the soap bubble explode. And he launched the light inside it and he saw some branching. He tried it again and again and he improved these bubbles and it continued to have branching.
In the experiment, we create a soap bubble which thickness is 1 millionth of a meter, and we couple to this soap bubble an optical fiber, and this optical fiber emits a laser beam into the soap film. The soap film acts as a two-dimensional waveguide and guides this light. The random structure of the soap film is supposed to defocus and ruin the structure of light, but yet it leaves the light focused for long distances, and this is very surprising.
We didn't know what it is, so he came to me and I didn't know what it is either. And we talked to Miguel, who at that time was my postdoc. We started to break our heads and we understood that we have a universal phenomenon that was discovered in electronic microscope, and now we see it for the first time in light.
What we did here is the first observation of branch flow of light. We're very familiar with the fact that when we have a wave, for example, a sound wave, a water wave, an electron or light that is propagating in an homogeneous medium, these waves will spread. But for different kinds of mediums, wave can behave in a very different way. For example, when we have a disordered medium where the variations are not random but they are smooth, like a landscape of mountains and valleys, we will have a very peculiar effect. In this case, the waves are going to form channels that are going to start dividing and they will form a beautiful pattern that resembles the branches of a tree.
And there everything started. So we took some time to understand the theory and to do a lot of new experiments. Eventually it opens a new direction in optics and photonics, the branch flow of light.
The point is that once you demonstrate it with optics, you have the whole toolbox, the whole arsenal of optics to play with. And optics is very flexible, is very powerful, and I'm confident that now we will be able to dive into this phenomenon in much more detail and also use it in order to study some other phenomena that we haven't studied yet. I believe that it will lead to further exciting results.
This is really goes along with the education that I give to the students. The experiments have their own rights. You see something and you don't need always to go and compare it to a known theory. Rather, you need to think about it as an explorer, and if you don't understand it, go and try to understand it, because often it opens new horizons. This is the beauty of experimental science.